and welcome to this full body sock workout. You're going to need socks on your feet, and then we will be putting socks on our hands as well. So make sure you have space, make sure you've got socks, and we're going to get started straight away. So make sure you're nice and warm. Okay, getting ready for a reverse lunge and then a side lunge. Off you go, back, and then slide the foot out to the side. So we're keeping the weight on that one leg, and then the opposite leg is either sliding behind or sliding out to the side. So you've got full pressure over on that one side. Try and get as low in that lunge as you can. You have 10 seconds. Three, two, one. Okay, 15 seconds rest. We're gonna do the exact same thing on the other side. Shake it out, release that leg. 5 seconds. Okay, off you go. Reverse lunge and then all the way out to the side. Try and slide that foot as far as you can behind you and then far as you can out to the side. Keep the core braced and the spine long. It's going to test your balance as well, so make sure you keep that core connected. You have just 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Okay, nice. So you want to put the socks on your hands now, so you can slide the hands across the floor. You're going to come into your high plank position. Hands under shoulders. Okay, lift up into plank. You're going to slide one hand around, cleaning the floor, and then you're going to draw knee to elbow. So slide circular motion outwards, and then draw knee to elbow, and then swap. So we're sliding the hand across the floor, keep the abs braced, the spine long, and then draw the knee towards the elbow. You can do this with your knees on the floor if you need a little bit more support for your low back. You have 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Nice, okay. So keep those socks on your hands. We're gonna move into press-ups now. So bringing yourself back up into that high plank position. We're gonna slide out into a press-up. Off you go. And then the feet are gonna open out. So we slide the feet open and then we slide the hands open. Now that's really quite hard. So if you need to step the hands out instead, you can. I do switch to this later on. So we slide feet out, slide feet in, and then slide hands out and slide hands in. Last few seconds left. Really push through. And rest. Okay, 15 seconds. Take those socks off your hands now. You are done with those. Bring the mat if you'd like. Okay, so hands underneath the shoulders, and we're going to either rest on the tops of the feet, or you can tuck the toes, and you're going to slide the knees in towards your chest. So as you slide the knees in, really pull the abdominals in close and squeeze with the core. You have just 10 seconds. Squeeze the belly, squeeze the knees in close to the chest. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, rest. Okay, 15 seconds, breathe. You're gonna come back up into a high plank in a minute, and we're gonna take a twisted mountain climber. And you're gonna tuck the toes under, and you're gonna draw the knee across. So draw that knee across to opposite elbow. So twist and draw that knee across. Working obliques, working the belly. Try and keep the spine long. If you need to bring the knees down, you can here. You have 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1, rest. Okay, you're coming up onto your backs now, so turn over, release down, feet on the floor. We're gonna lift up into a bridge. 3 seconds. Off you go. So lift up, squeeze the hips up, and then slide the feet away from you, and then draw them in and release the hips down. This is really targeting the hamstrings. So you can see I've got these little dinosaur arms. That just makes them a little bit harder without the use of the hand on the floor. So really, really squeeze into the backs of the legs. You have just 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. Okay, one more exercise. And these you can put the socks back on the hands to slide across if you wish. We're gonna come into a kneeling position, all fours. So lifting the knees up, we're gonna slide to the side. A few steps one way, and then a few steps the other way. So we're hovering the knees just to make it more of a challenge for the core. And you want to think about bracing the abs, lengthening the spine, and drawing the shoulders down in the back. Okay, you're nearly there with this one. Keep squeezing. Longer rest is coming up. And rest. Okay, so this is your longer breather. That is round one, done. Okay, getting ready for round two now. This time you're really, really gonna go for it. You've got 10 seconds of this break left. Okay, so get ready for that reverse lunge. Off you go, sending that knee back behind and then out to the side. So you are working all of the lower body here, making sure that the inner thigh is really squeezing as we draw that leg back in. Can you sink any lower in that supporting leg? Just 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. Okay. So we're gonna swap over to the other leg now, let them have a little bit of a breather. You have 5 seconds. Off you go. Lunging it back and then lunging it to the side. So just sliding that foot along the floor. Feel the resistance as you draw that leg back in. That's going to make your legs work even harder. Really push into that supporting leg, feeling the foot on the floor. Less than 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Rest. Okay. Socks on the hands. Coming up into your high plank position. 5 seconds. Okay, brace the abs. We take a big circle, almost like you're cleaning the floor, multitasking. And then that knee comes in. So try and keep the pelvis as steady as possible as you do all of this. It's going to really help your core work even harder. 10 seconds. Big circles with those hands. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Okay, you have 15 seconds now to breathe. If you're as sweaty as me right now, you can use the socks to dry your face. Okay, you're gonna get ready for those push-ups in a minute. 2, 1, off you go. Okay, so we're opening out the feet and then opening out the arms. Remember, you can walk the hands out, press up, and then walk the hands back in again, if that's better. Okay, so you have just 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. 15 seconds to breathe. Okay, so take those socks off. You are gonna get ready to come up into high plank and draw the knees into the belly. Off you go. So in that high plank, squeeze the abs to draw the knees in. Lengthen the spine. You can breathe out to draw the knees in. That's going to make it even more effective at recruiting the abdominal muscles really, really well. Okay, you have just 10 seconds to go. Three, two, one, and rest. Have a moment to breathe. You have just 10 seconds left of your breather. And we're gonna come up into our high plank again, and you're gonna draw knee to opposite elbow. Get ready. Off you go. So high plank, and draw that knee across. You can take these as fast or as slow as you need to for your body. Remember that foot sliding across the floor, really squeeze the belly. Or you can sink lower in your range, so really bend into that leg. You've only got 10 seconds left, so really, really make this leg work hard for this last set. Three, two, one, and rest. You might want to stretch that leg out, I was definitely feeling it. 10 seconds of your rest, I'm gonna switch over to the other side. 5 seconds. Off you go. So sending that leg back behind you. Really try and send it as far away as you can. And then further out to the side. Really, really send it away from you. Can you push any more into that supporting leg? Power up through the supporting side. Less than 10 seconds. Three, two, one, and have a rest. Okay, so we're gonna put the socks on to the hands. Getting ready for your last set of these in high plank. We're gonna clean the floor and then draw the knees into the elbows. So off we go. Big circle with the hands, and then the knee travels up to the same elbow. So as you're getting tired now, maybe you can feel it in the shoulders supporting you, maybe you can feel it in the arms and the legs and the core. Really think about all of the muscles that you're using to support you in this exercise. You're so close, last 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, and rest. Okay, nice. So this is probably the hardest exercise next, I'd say. Are you gonna drop down into that push-up? Option two, step the hands out into the push-up. So get ready, brace the abs, legs out, off you go. So, opening the legs wide, and then we're sinking into that push-up, or as you can see here, I start to step the hands because my push-up just can't hack it. So you can choose what you do. You've only got 10 seconds though, so whatever it is you're doing, make sure it's the right workout for your body. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Okay, so socks off the hands. Maybe using that mat if you'd like to support the hands on the floor. You're gonna draw the knees in for a core. 3 seconds. Off you go. So knees coming in, pulling them in closely to the chest. Now you really should be feeling this in the abdominals now. It should be, you know, quite hard work to draw those knees into the chest. Hopefully you can feel that. You have just 10 seconds. Make it work. 3, 2, 1, and rest. Okay, how are we feeling? Are you ready? Last exercise in your plank position. We're gonna bring the hands underneath the shoulders and we're gonna send that knee to opposite elbow. Off you go. So send that knee across. Remember, this can be more of a cardio element. If you speed it up, you do it quite quickly, it's gonna make your heartbeat faster, it's gonna be harder work. So really twisting in, using the obliques as you twist. You've got the last 10 seconds of this, really make it count. 3 seconds, and rest. Okay, last two exercises, you've got this. So open your backs, lying down, feet in line with the knees. You have 5 seconds, get ready for that bridge. Off you go, lifting the hips up, slide them away, and then down again. Really squeeze into the backs of the legs. Glutes on fire, hamstrings on fire. You have just 10 seconds. Rest. Okay, last exercise. Over onto your front in a kneeling crouching position. Socks on hands, hands under the shoulders, abdominal braced. Tuck your toes, lift your knees, and off you go. Side traveling. One way, and then take it back the other way. This is your last exercise, so it should be hard. You should feel like you've worked hard now. Really, really push it all the way to the end. Keep the body strong, keep the mind engaged and focused. Last few seconds. You have 3, 2, and 1. Rest. Well done. Make sure you rehydrate, make sure you stretch, and thank you for joining.